Good morning, my dear students. I am Mohammed Bahauddin, working as an assistant professor in IS Engineering College, which is affiliated to the Sumania University in Hyderabad. So today in this session, we are going to learn design a general bearing for a steam turbine. Okay. Design a general bearing for a steam turbine whose shaft is supported on two bearings. So this is our shaft. This shaft is resting between two bearings, one at each side of the turbine, toward the left side of the turbine as well as toward the right side of the turbine, and is coupled with the generator for the power production purpose. The weight of the turbine with the shaft is measured as 40 kilonewton. The shaft is rotating at a speed of 1500 rpm. This diameter of the shaft is given, 100 mm is given over here. Let us see over here. This is the generator. Generate the electricity is connected to the shaft. Shaft is connected to the coupling. Flange coupling we are using over here, and again it is shaft, it is a hinge in between these two bearing, and on which the turbine is mounted. Clear? So let us see over here. The first thing is here, the weight of the turbine with the shaft is measured as 40 kilonewton. So on this weight is acting on this bearing, these two bearing, how much? 40 kilonewton weight is acting. So this means that the load toward the left side, 20 kilonewton load is acting toward left side, as well as 20 kilonewtons load is acting toward the right hand side. Clear? Then speed of rotation of the shaft, the speed of rotation of the shaft is how much is there? 1500 rpm is there. Clear? Then diameter of the shaft is how much is there here? 100 mm is given. If you want to find out the radius, diameter by 2, then you will get 50 mm radius you will get. In the step number 1, what we need to find out? Our intention is there, we want to find out the length of the general bearing we need to find out. If you want to find out the length of the general bearing, then you have to refer the table number 15.7, page number 366 for steam turbine. So from that one, you can easily get this value L by D equal to 1 to 2%. So if you take the average 1 plus 2 by 2, then you will get the average is 1.2. Clear? Then L by D equal to 1.2. Just you need to multiply over here 1.2 into D. So 1.2 diameter, how much is given over here? 100 mm is given. If you multiply, then you will get the length of the bearing is how much is there? The length or contact length of the bearing with the general is given here, 120 mm. After that, our intention is there, we need to find out the pressure develop, we need to find out. If you want to find out the pressure develop, we have the formula is P equal to W by 2 into R into L, we need to find out. W nothing but the how much load is acting on the each bearing, 2 into radius of the shaft into length of the bearing, or length of the shaft we can say that. Clear? Then the load, how much is acting on the each bearing? The load is acting on the each bearing, toward this side is 20, toward this side is also 20. So we are taking over here is 20 into 10 power of 3. So 2 as it is, R is how much is there? 50. And L is how much is there? 120. If you divide the whole the value, then you will get the answer is how much? 1.67 N/mm². After that, whatever we obtain the pressure value, how much we obtain the pressure value? 1.67 N/mm². So is within the safe range or not? So we have to check it from the table number 15.7, page number 366. For a steam turbine, for the maximum pressure should be lies in between how much? 0.7 to 1.9 MN/mm². So our pressure is how much is getting? 1.67. So it is lies in between. In between it lies. So that's what our problem is safe. Whatever the pressure is acting on it, it's totally safe. After that, our operating temperature of the bearing is how much is given over here? 30 degree. And this ambient temperature is 30 degree we are taking from our side. After that, the viscosity of the lubricant we need to find out over here. If you want to find out the viscosity of lubricant, you have to refer the table number 15.7, page number 366, you have to refer it. For the permissible value, we have the formula Zn by P permissible equal to how much? 14.50. If you refer the table number 15.7, page number 366, then you will get the value of permissible value is 14.50. After that, we have to select the SA 30i and operating temperature is 70 and Z value dynamic viscosity is 18 into CP. Okay, so 18 into 10 power 3 N/sec/m². So we have to refer from the viscosity chart. If you refer, then only you will get this value. Please use the design data handbook, otherwise you will not get the concept. Remember, okay? And to find out the specific gravity of lubricant oil, we need to find out. So we have the formula density into density of 15 minus of 0.0063, operating temperature minus of 15. So if you want to find out the density of 15, then you have to refer this SA 30 oil from the table number 15.1 and page number 360, then you will get the value is 0.9263. Put over here 0.9263 minus 0.0063 and this operating temperature is 70 minus of 50. If you calculate with the help of calci, then you will get the specific gravity of the lubricant oil is how much is there? 0.578. After that, our intention is that we want to find out the density of the liquid we need to find out. If you want to find out the density of the liquid, we have the specific formula. Specific gravity always should be equal to the density of the liquid by density of the water. So specific gravity, we have the formalized density of 70, this value, specific gravity value equal to density of liquid is unknown, we need to find out. Density of water always will be 1000. So this specific gravity, how much we got here? 0.5798 equal to density by 1000. If you multiply this over here, then you will get the density of the liquid is, density of liquid is how much is there? 0.5978 into 1000, then you will get the answer is 579.8 kg/m³. After the getting the value of density of the liquid, we need to find out the kinematic viscosity. We need to find out. We have the formula for the kinematic viscosity equal to dynamic viscosity by density. The kinematic viscosity is that K equal to dynamic viscosity, how much we got here? 18 into 10 power 3. And this density is how much that here? Density is 579.8. So after that, if you calculate with the help of calci, then you will get the answer of kinematic viscosity is how much is there? 0.00031045 m² per second. Okay, after that, we need to check hydrodynamic theory of lubrication. We have to check. So Zn by P operating temperature should be lesser than or not. If it is lesser than this permissible value, if it is lesser than the Zn by P, then our design is safe. Unsafe if Zn by P permissible, if it is greater than the Zn by P operating, then our design is completely safe. Completely safe. This permissible always should be greater than the operating. If it is greater than operating, then our design is safe. Otherwise, our design is fail. Okay, then let us see over here Zn by P operating. So Z, nothing but the dynamic viscosity is how much we got, 18 into 10 power of minus 3 into speed is how much is there, 1500 rpm. And the P, how much we got here, 1.67. If you divide the whole the value with the help of Kelsey, then you will get the answer is 16.1676. That is the value of operating. Zn by P permissible is how much, 14.50 we got it. After that, first check it over here. Zn by P permissible is lesser than Zn by P operating. For that reason, our design is unsafe. If our design is unsafe, again you have to go for choose the SA20I and the operating temperature is how much is there, 70 degrees Celsius. And the from the viscosity chart, we need to find out the value of Z equal to 14 cp is 14 into 10 power minus 3 Newton second per meter square. After that, Zn by P operating equal to Z is how much is there, 14 into 10 power of minus 3 and N how much is there, 1500. Clear? And the pressure is how much is there, 1.67. If you divide the whole the value, then you will get the answer is 12.574. So let us see over here, this Zn by P operating is lesser than permissible. If it is lesser than permissible, then our design is safe. After that, our intention is there, we want to find out the radial clearance. We need to find out, if you want to find out the radial clearance, you have to refer the table number 15.7, page number 366. From a steam turbine, C by R is equal to 0.001. C is equal to, if you multiply over here as 0.001 into R, then you will get the radial clearance is how much, 0.05 mm. After the getting the value, we need to find out the coefficient of friction by the Mackey equation. We need to find out. So refer this Mackey coefficient of friction by Mackey equation, page, refer this equation from the page number 353, equation is 15.4b. Ka, how much is there, 0.195 into 10 power of 6. Z is how much is there, 14. Dynamic viscosity is how much is there, 14 into 10 power of minus 3. N is how much is there, N in RPS, 25 by P is how much is there, 1.67. And R, how much is there here, 50. By C is how much is there, 0.05 mm. Into 10 power of minus 10 plus delta F is how much is there, 0.02. so if you select for the full bearing, clear, then if you calculate that with the help of Kelsey, then you will get the coefficient of friction by the Mackey equation is how much we got, 0.006085. okay, after that our intention is there, we want to find out the heat generated, we need to find out, as well as heat dissipated, we need to find out, as well as we need to find out the amount of artificial cooling is required in between the general as well as in between the bearing, we need to find out. So first of all, what I'm doing over here, we are finding the heat generated. We are finding over here heat generated equal to coefficient of friction into load into speed of general. This coefficient of frictions by the Mackey equations, how much we got, 0.006085 into load, how much is acting to, so from this 20 into the power minus 3. So if you want to find out the V value, the rubbing velocity value, we have the formulas V is equal to pi d n by 1000. Pi as it is, diameter is how much, 100, and speed is how much, 25 rps by 1000. Then you will get 7.85 meter per second. If you substitute over here, as well as if you multiply over here, then you will get the answer is 955.345 joule per second. That is the value of heat generated. After that, our intention is that we need to find out the heat dissipated. We need to find out. We have the formula is, you have to refer this heat dissipated formula is from the page number 360 and equation is 15.11 C1. Then TP minus TA plus 18 by KP whole square into LD into 10 power of minus 6. So 1 by 2, this instead of TB, we can represent over here, or this operating temperature minus ambient temperature plus 18 by K into P into length of the bearing into diameter into 10 power of minus 6. Then 1 by 2, TO is how much is there, 70, TA how much is there, 30 plus 18 by 0.273 whole square into length how much, 120 into D how much, 100 in 2 10 power 6. If you are calculated with the help of calci, then you will get the answer of heat dissipated. Answer is 63.47 joule per second. Our main intention is that we want to find out the amount of how much amount of artificial cooling is required in between the general as well as in between the bearing. We need to find out. So for that reason, we have to use the formula is Hg minus of Sd. So Hg, how much is there? The amount of heat generated is 955.345 minus Sd, how much is there? 63.47. So if you substitute the value, then you will get the answer is amount of artificial cooling is required in between the general and bearing is 891.875 joule per second. Okay, I hope so no one is having the confusion regarding up to over here. If you have the confusion regarding in these sessions, please write down the comment box, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel here. Thank you.